In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. Today is the first Sunday of Lent, and the Church want to put the goal very clear ahead of us for this Lent. Why are we fasting? Do you have a problem that you are fasting for? Are you worrying about something? Is there something that you're thinking about, praying about, worrying about? And today's gospel set the goal clear. Put all these things aside during this time and focus on the kingdom. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. And as you know, that in the beginning of this year, like every year, we have a goal for us as a church. And the goal for us this year is lead us into your kingdom. We explained that in the beginning of the year and how God wants us to go deeper in his kingdom. Let me remind you a little bit about what is the kingdom of God. But before we say that, maybe let's see people who were looking for kingdoms. If you look at history, or if you know some philosophy, one of the big ideas philosophers thought about is to have a perfect city or a perfect world where there is no crime, there are no problems, no financial problems, no one is taking anything by force from anyone, everybody's helpful, all people are great, wonderful, no one is like harming anyone. And they kept adding and dreaming about these cities and building philosophies about it, but nothing took place. None of these took place. Then people wanted to take their own kingdoms in their hands, and every king, every president thought that he would be the best and he would know how to direct the ship and how to lead the people, and how to make a good kingdom or a perfect kingdom. But no one was able to. The Jewish people thought about the same. God told them, you are a people of kingdom. Till now, they're trying to build an earthly kingdom. And the more they try, the harder it gets, the complicated it becomes, and they reach nowhere. And it's not the search of the Jews, and it's not the search of the kingdoms, but it's the search of every human being. The perfect city, the perfect condition, the perfect case scenario, the rest. Where is that city? Where is that place where I don't have to worry about school? And I don't have to worry about papers to give, and I don't have to worry about deadlines at work. I don't have to worry about bills. I don't have to worry about kids. Where is that place? Does it really exist or not? And Jesus is the only one who came to preach a perfect kingdom, the kingdom of God. Or as it was said in the Gospel of Matthew, the kingdom of heaven. And the disciples were confused about it. People were confused about it. They thought maybe he's trying to tell them, if you behave that way, then we will have a perfect kingdom. If you obey the commandments. So what's new? All the Old Testament came telling the same thing. If you obey the commandments, if you do all these things, things will be good for you. Didn't work. We couldn't do it. It might work, but we couldn't do it. So what's the solution? What are you bringing new to us? And that's the whole meaning of the kingdom of God. Many times, the message that Jesus sent the disciples for, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, or the kingdom of heaven is at hand. It's very close, very close, very near. Where is it? And then he explained and he said, the kingdom of God is within you. And it is a treasure. It is the place that you are dreaming about. It is the lost paradise, where really you don't have to worry about anything. This real? Yes. But the problem is, as he explained in Matthew 13, when he talked about the parables of the kingdom, he said, but listen, the kingdom of God is like a treasure hidden in a field. It's a treasure hidden in a field. And another parable, he said, the kingdom of heaven is like a yeast put in a dough, and it makes the dough grow, but it is something very, very small, internal, and its work is internal. You might not see it from the outside. You might never see it from the outside. You might never see the people who are living in the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is not heaven to come, but the kingdom of God is heaven within, where Christ is truly the king, where he is number one. And those who have experienced that, they said, this is heaven on earth. Some of them tasted it in practicing the presence of God. We have studied this book before. You know, Brother Lawrence, who was a French monk, who continually practiced being in the presence of God. We've studied before, we've seen before people who have experienced no worrying about anything in life when they experienced Jesus' prayer, which is the same, being in the presence of God, putting him first, making him king, making him a priority, making him the goal, the reason behind their existence and the motivation behind everything they do. Easier said than done. This is something easy to say, but it's hard to do. As a matter of fact, the kingdom of God is not to be explained, but to be tasted and tried. And a lot of times, God in his faithfulness let you and me experience the kingdom in a very small portion that hopefully we will take it on after that. Maybe after a certain prayer. Maybe in Holy Week. Maybe in a retreat. Maybe in a time when you were in trouble and you prayed from all your heart and you felt something joyful, glorious, something that you cannot explain to people. And as much as you try to put it in words, it doesn't come to words. Something to be tasted, something sweet, something beautiful, something that doesn't have any sadness or worrying, or that has nothing to do with the outside. The outside could be in pain. As I said, some people experience the presence of God, experienced heaven in the midst of their trial, in the midst of their pain. They experience that. So many times, people come in a trial and then they decide to pray. They decide to do something. They decide to go out of their comfort zone to do something. One of them was relatives of mine. Their son got into a car accident and he was in a coma. And he told them basically, just it's within 24 hours, he'll be gone. Because the trauma the trauma was in the head, so it was useless. So the father and mother decided to spend a whole day in prayer. And they prayed and prayed and prayed. And there is something about the continuous prayer is like, when you go on, you reach a boredom. And the boredom sometimes becomes very, very hard, very strong, becomes very heavy, or maybe sleepiness or something, or being tired. But they continued, like many, many, many of the fathers who experienced that. When they continued, regardless of what they feel from the outside, they experienced the heavenly joy. They experienced something. They couldn't tell what it is. Was it a vision? Was it God being present? What was it? And they left prayer feeling that their son is okay. And regardless what's going to happen to him, he's okay. He's in good hands, and their heart was comforted. And God's will was to save him. So the following day they went, and miraculously he was awake, and he basically lost his life and got it back. But not necessarily because of the answer, you know, to prayer, they experienced the joy. They experienced the joy at the time of prayer, at the time of leaving everything and just putting their hope, their goal, their focus on the Lord and Him alone. The only one who was able to do that was the Lord Jesus Christ. And He said, this might be very hard for you, but I will teach you, and I will help you, and I will give you the Holy Spirit to teach you how to experience that. But the kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is so near. Don't look far. Don't look outside. Don't look at things. Don't look at situations. It's much closer than what you think. But like any other treasure, it is a treasure. But the treasure is hidden. You won't walk in the street and find treasures, would you? Nobody. You won't go in Giant or Safeway and find them putting pearls instead of the tomatoes. You wouldn't find that. No, if you want pearls, you go to a special store where there is a security guard is standing there, and you can't even touch unless there's someone who can show you what that is. And even the expensive stuff, they don't put it outside. They hide it in a special safe. The kingdom of God is hidden. But I hope not from us, the believers. But we have a special eye. That's why Jesus said, watch your eye. How do you see? Where is your treasure? Are you aware of your life? Where is your treasure? And He said that, for where your treasure, there your heart will be also. Our entire life is a search for the treasure. It's like the cartoons, the movies, the pirates. The entire movie is about searching for the treasure. But hopefully, we can find it. We can find it in the Lord Jesus Christ Himself. How? Again, this is something that we taste. The church is giving us fastings, prayers, extra fastings, extra prayers. Go ahead. Do your part. But discover, where is your treasure? Where is your treasure? And maybe you will find your treasure in things, in people. Cry to Him and tell Him, I want to find you. I want to know you like never before. I want to find you as the treasure of my life. This is the kingdom of God, and this is the kingdom of heaven, where you find the real treasure. When the Lord Jesus becomes your life. Like St. Paul when he said, for me to live is Christ. How do I do that? I don't know. That's why we're fasting. That's why we're praying. You discover the wrong treasures, get them out and put the real treasure. And let me tell you a secret before we conclude here. This is the Sunday of the treasures. And the message is the kingdom of God is the real treasure that will never be taken away from you. Anything else you invest in will make you sad one day, will upset you one day, will disappoint you one day. And if you put all your investment in it, it may destroy you one day. But now, he's saying, look at the real treasure and invest in that. Maybe the Lord Jesus Christ is not your treasure, is not the expensive pearl yet, is not the treasure of your life yet. But guess what? The treasure is usually accumulated. That's what we invest in every day. And if you understand investment, investment starts very, very, very small, but grows over the years. Very little could grow exponentially in an unbelievable way. Don't underestimate the little things, the little beginnings. Maybe his place in your heart is 10%. That's okay. It's not the end of the world. But if all your investment is in these 10%, next year they will be 15. And the year after, they will be 25. And the year after, they will be 35. And so on. The return on investment with the kingdom is extremely high. Exponential growth. But if I'm not growing every year, and the Lord's position in my heart is still low, I'm still angry and sad, I'm still distracted, disappointed, I still look for things, maybe the treasure or the investment was in the wrong thing. So it's a refocus. It's a beginning. Put this in your prayer. Don't fast for something else. It's not the time to fast to decide on a job or a relationship. It's not the time to fast for school. But it's time to fast for that treasure. That Jesus would become your treasure. The treasure of your life. That you find the kingdom now and here. Because don't wait until you discover something else up there. The kingdom of heaven is near. The kingdom of God is at hand. The kingdom of God is within you. The kingdom of God is joy and peace in the Holy Spirit. The kingdom of God is joy regardless of the situation. The kingdom of God is a treasure that you grow year after year. And the treasure is the Lord Jesus Christ. When he is your pearl, when he is number one, then you are in the kingdom of God. When you get upset, disappointed, sad, then he's not number one. Something is stealing your heart away from him. That is okay. But hopefully year after year, take away from me this. Take away from me this lust. Take away from me this sadness. Take away from me this desire to become something. Take away from me the ego that is like bothering me, making me angry. Take away from me anything the work, the dream, whatever it is, and let me have it in you. That is the real treasure. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.